the Stewart family are proud mullet wearers. Three generations sport the distinctive haircut and they're not changing.
Oh, that looks nice. It's a hairstyle. That's all it comes down to, like my curly hair. It's the same thing.
I had a mullet, Mr. Speaker. I had a mullet. It's long gone now.
From Canberra to Townsville, it's all anyone is talking about.
I've had a mullet now for about 2.5 years. Yeah, loving the lifestyle and the looks I get.
From three-year-olds to the Federal Treasurer, Josh Frydenberg.
Well, I can confirm to the House the last time the Labor Party delivered a surplus, I had a mullet, Mr. Speaker.
And he produced the photos to prove it. Sadly, it appears the Treasurer now couldn't grow a mullet if he tried.
It's long gone, because God only created a few perfect heads and the rest he put hair on, Mr. Speaker.
I want my mullet back.
Since I was 13, that was when I started growing from 13.
Up in Townsville, Granddad Gary Stewart has had a mullet for years. His son has one and so does his grandson, Brock.
Seems to suit Brock. If it didn't, we would have shaved him off and just kept the normal hair.
And do you get many comments from people?
Yeah, we do. We do. You know how they say rock on or I love the mullet.
Brock's mum, Michaela Stewart, is hoping her baby son, Chevy, will also rock a mullet.
And you were telling me he doesn't like having it cut too much.
No, he doesn't. So all he gets is a trim.
It's a pleasure to cut them, you know.
Barber Rob McRae says he now cuts 3 or 4 mullets a week.
They're coming back.
Yeah, 100%, man.
And where there's mullets, there's always fast cars.
So you're a Holden fan, obviously.
Yes. Only Holden.
Only Holden. You've even named the boys after them.
I did. I named my first son Brock after my car, and because we idolise Peter Brock, we're massive Peter Brock fans. And I've always loved the name Chevy, so.
Chevy.
The day we caught up with Michaela and her family, they were celebrating the local council's approval of a motorsport track on land outside the city.
That's the news we've been waiting for. Because, you know, in the future, my kids are going to be in cars as well.
Providing a place where people of all ages can go and express their need for speed, well, that's just good, isn't it?
Pat Driscoll from Drive It North Queensland says now all they have to do is raise the $18 million to build it. And he's hoping the coming election will see the pollies open their wallets.
Townsville is, I think, the tightest seat, 36 votes or something like that. So, yeah, it's an opportunity for all parties to step up and make a commitment.
Definitely for the younger kids to go on a track and, you know, race their mates or, you know, just to learn how to drive.
And I think it was Pat that said, wasn't it, if they're spending money on motorsports, they don't have money to spend on drugs.
Exactly.
For now, the only thing Michaela has to worry about are the trolls, who attacked her after three-year-old Brock's mullet got national publicity.
Yep, over a three-year-old boy with a haircut. It got very negative. I mean, we get people that say, oh, cut it off, but he loves it. So why would I take it off him when he loves it?
I guess that's it. If you've got something that works for him.
Exactly, and he rocks it.
He does.
Tell him to give you a mullet shake and he'll give you a mullet shake.
He does rock it. Michaela says they're planning a mullet run soon to raise money for their race track.